Hello friends, you are welcome in video lecture series. So today I am going to discuss the one topic from Botany paper 2nd. The name of the today's topic is bryophytes. So under the heading of this bryophytes, initially I am going to introduce this topic. So as far as this group, bryophyte group is concerned, the bryophytes are the plants which are coming under cryptogamic plants. The bryophyte is a unique and important group of cryptogamic plants which is much more evolved than another cryptogamic plants like algae as well as fungi. The bryophytic plants are intermediate plants in between chalophytes and pteridophytes. The bryophytic plants are represented by near about 960 genera and 24,000 species which are distributed in tropical as well as temperate regions of the world. So as far as the general characters of these bryophytic plants are concerned, the bryophytic plants are showing diverse type of habitat. That means most of the bryophytic plants, they are terrestrial, that means first adapted plants for the land are the bryophytes. That means most of the bryophytic plants species are terrestrial. Some species of the bryophyte are also found in water. That means some species are aquatic. For example, Rickettsia prutens is an example of aquatic form of the bryophyte. Some species are epiphytic one. So if we observe the mosses, the third class of bryophyte known as mossy or mosses, these mosses are mostly growing on the plants, other plants, epiphytically. That means most of the bryophytes are terrestrial, some bryophytes are aquatic, they are found in water, some bryophytes are epiphytic, that means growing on the other plants, some bryophytes are saprophytic. For example, Cryptothallus mirabilis, this species of the bryophyte is growing on dead and decaying organic matter. That means it is an example of saprophytic bryophyte. So this bryophytic plant, important character of bryophytic plant, all bryophytes require water for fertilization. So this is the incomplete adaptation for land habit or terrestrial habit. That means water is required for aquatic plants, but this most of the species of the bryophytes are not aquatic. Most of the species are terrestrial. Even though bryophytic plants are terrestrial one, most of the plants are terrestrial one, but all bryophytes require water for fertilization. So this is the incomplete adaptation for terrestrial habit. That's why the bryophytes are considered as a plant amphibians. Bryophytes are considered as a plant amphibians because of requirement of water for fertilization. Each and every bryophyte or all bryophytes shows two distinct generations in its life cycle: gametophytic generation and sporophytic generation. The main plant body of all bryophytes is a gametophyte. It is independent. It is long-lived. Sporophyte is the second phase in its life cycle. Sporophyte depends on gametophyte. It is short-lived. Sporophyte is short-lived. That means in the single life cycle, each and every bryophyte shows alternation of generation. That means gametophytic phase alternates with sporophytic phase. Then if we observe the different bryophyte members, which are included or divided into three different classes, like Hepaticopsida, Anthoceratopsida, and Bryopsida. So these primitive forms of the bryophyte, they are generally prostrate. That means they are creeping. They are superficially growing on the moist and shady places, on the moist soils, on the moist rocks, moist areas, etc. That means the primitive forms are generally prostrate one. They are proximally flattened. While evolved forms are erect one. For example, mosses. They show the erect stem-like structure, leaf-like appendages, as well as sporophyte, which is differentiated into four seta and capsule. That means the erect forms are found in higher bryophytes or evolved forms, and primitive forms are showing prostate type of habit. Then, if we observe the anatomy of the bryophyte shows simple tissue organization. The plant body of bryophyte shows only one type of tissue, that means parenchyma. That means there is no tissue differentiation in bryophytes, and all bryophytes are lacking the conducting tissues like xylem and phloem. Then, if we see the mode of reproduction in bryophytes, bryophytic plant reproduces by vegetative methods of reproduction as well as sexual method of reproduction. As far as vegetative mode of reproduction is concerned, vegetatively bryophytic plant produces by the death and decay of the older part of the thallus. For example, if this is the thallus of Ixia, this is the thallus of Marchesia, if older part of this thallus decays, it gets separated, and this separated part act as an independent thallus, or independent plant. That means due to death and decay of the older parts of the thallus, many bryophytic plants may be developed from single plant. This is one method from vegetative reproduction. Then, with the help of adventitious buds, bryophyte may reproduce by vegetative method. Then, with the help of tubers. So, these tubers are the special kind of structures which are produced at the terminal ends of the thallus of some bryophyte species, and with the help of the tuber also, new plants are also developed, regenerated from these tubers. In some bryophytic plants, the gimma cup or gimma bodies are developed, and with the help of this gimma body, another plant, new plants are also developed. That means the death and decay of older parts of thallus, adventitious buds, and through tubers and through gimma bodies. These are the different methods of vegetative reproduction of the bryophyte. Then, bryophyte also reproduces by sexual method. The sexual reproduction in bryophyte is studied under the heading of oogamous type of reproduction. That means, you know very well, in lower plants like algae, isogamous, anisogamous, and oogamous, three types of reproductions are observed, but most of the bryophyte shows the oogamous type of sexual reproduction. That means male gametes and female gametes, these two gametes are produced. Out of these two gametes, female gamete is stationary and male gamete is having motility. That means male gamete moves through different agencies. In bryophyte, the male reproductive structures are transported from male reproductive structures, male gametes are transported from male reproductive structures towards the female reproductive structure and approaches with the help of agencies like wind. That means this kind of reproduction in which female reproductive structure is stationary and male reproductive structure is having movement or motility power is commonly studied under the heading of oogamous type of sexual reproduction. The male reproductive structure in all bryophytes is known as anthidium. Female reproductive structure in all bryophytes is known as archegonium. So this anthidium and archegonium, these are developed endogenously, internally in the thallus tissue. When plant becomes mature, it produces the male and female reproductive structures in the form of anthidia and archegonia endogenously inside the thallus tissue, So if we observe this structure of anthidium, anthidium is more or less club shaped structure. It is having multicellular stalk, it is short one, and this is the body of anthidium, spherical. So this body of anthidium is enclosed by sterile jacket layer. Inside the jacket layer, there are many endothelial cells or anthidium mother cells are there. Each anthidium mother cell after meiosis give rise to the actual male sex cells, commonly known as anthrozoites. Archegonium is the female reproductive structure. It is having two regions. Apical narrow region is known as neck region. Basal bulbous portion is known as fender region. Fender region contains two cells, fender canal cell and egg cell containing egg nucleus. Apical narrow neck region is made up of two rows of neck cells, two to four cover cells at the tip, and centrally neck region possesses neck canal cells. So after maturity, this anthidium produces anthrozoites, archegonium, cover cells, neck canal cells disintegrates, and fender canal cell also disintegrate, passage is created, and anthrozoites are transported from anthidium towards the archegonium with the help of drop of water, and fertilization occurs. What is the fertilization product? The product of fertilization is zygote. From zygote, embryo is developed, and from embryo, sporophyte is developed. That means, for this process of fertilization, you know what is a fertilization? Union of male gamete with female gamete is commonly called as fertilization. So this process of fertilization requires water. So after fertilization, there is a formation of zygote. From zygote, there is the formation of the embryo, and from embryo, this development of sporophyte begins. This sporophyte development begins in this fender region of archegonium. The nature of sporophyte in different classes of bryophyte is different. For example, in Hepatocopsida, for example, Lixia, sporophyte is very simple. It is showing only capsule region. Foot and seta region are totally absent. If we observe this sporophyte of Funaria, advanced bryophyte, evolved bryophyte, sporophyte is differentiated into foot, seta and capsule. Sporophyte is differentiated into foot, seta and capsule, distinct three regions. So this is the difference between the nature of sporophyte. In lower bryophytes like Lixia, it is represented by only capsule. In case of Funaria, sporophyte is differentiated into foot, seta and capsule. So after development of sporophyte, inside this capsule region, spores are produced. After meiotic division, haploid spores are produced. These spores are liberated from sporophyte. After dispersal of spores, when get suitable condition for germination, they germinate and it gives rise to gametophyte. That means in the single life cycle of bryophyte, the gametophytic phase alternates with sporophytic phase. That means each and every bryophyte shows alternation of generation in the single life cycle. So that's all about the general account of bryophyte introduction and general characters of bryophytes.